The global context in which this conference is being held is, at least for the business people, more complex, volatile, and unpredictable than ever before. We are living in an era of rapid business globalization, fight for clients and new markets, where business executives need to find new methods to succeed, need to adapt, need to face new challenges, to make strategic alliances and promote and protect their interests, to address the issues they confront, and develop their businesses under new paradigms, totally new paradigms that they are heavily influenced by global external factors, like geopolitical, economical, technological, and social ones. Sunday night, a Romanian businessman operating an ice factory, 3 million euro investment in Barcelona, was complaining on the TV that he's almost bankrupt because of the Catalan crisis. Just very few pubs and restaurants in Spain are buying his ice products because they are branded as being produced in Barcelona. Large EU tour agents decided not to send tourists to Catalonia, and the demand for his products dropped almost to zero even in Barcelona. The cruise ship are avoiding Barcelona nowadays. He was completely confused, and I guess he's not the only one. The solutions to his problem does not remain with his hands at all. These international developments create both opportunities and threats, even for companies that they think they act locally, but nothing is just locally today, and nothing seems to be protected against the influence of global actors. In order to operate sustainably and protect their interest in the markets, companies need to develop international competencies that enable them to create and cultivate and develop high-level relationships with interest groups, governmental, non-governmental, and private influential factors that are relevant for their activity. This requires a way of being which is specific to a diplomat. In this line, I like to stress that, in my opinion, international business is conducted together with governments and international and societal organizations. Of course, you need a good business idea. Of course, you need managerial skills and good people to act in your company. But that's not enough to develop the business internationally and on a long run. Business people should not underestimate the fact that a number of important factors, like states and multilateral organizations, they have interest in our region and they compete for influence, although they may be part of the European Union. States have their own interests, and companies need to pay attention to such particularities and cultivate the required relationships locally and internationally if they want to stay in business. I'll not go into detail on the second side, as Mr. Sean Riordan honors us with his presence today, and he will detail it later on. Diplomacy can provide visionary businessmen with kind of tools and methods that they need to succeed in the 21st century. They help them to take decisions in conditions of imperfect knowledge and uncertainty. They know how to play chess with opponents who may think differently to them. Business people need to learn to play 3D chess as well as Chinese chess. Otherwise, they will understand nothing from what is coming. Playing chess against yourself no longer works. Diplomacy means business may have a good sense, as nowadays every single ambassador has as his first priority to support business, increase exports, and attract investment in their own country. At the same time, large international companies are hiring former diplomats to help them navigate in this world. Former diplomats have already established strategic advisory companies in this respect, And so we see the beginning of a merging between diplomacy and business, and the migration of methods between them. What are the resources that diplomacy can provide to international business? Economic diplomacy resources are very important for a businessman that wants to do both international but local business. High level of contacts developed by the skilled diplomats in both home and host country. Public promotion tools at a reasonable cost and communication channels. Reputation and trust factor a businessman can take from a diplomat, it's a very valuable resource. Intelligence and pure market information centralized for a historical period of time are just few of the main needs for a company that want to do international business with less risks and at a decent cost. Negotiation strategies from business, from diplomacy can apply to business as well. Briefing, debriefing, and reporting are also methods that are being imported to business. There is a real need for business people to get new competencies from diplomacy, the traditional business school approach to planning and strategy in which decisions are taken in, based on business plans in conditions of perfect or near perfect knowledge are like playing chess against yourself. Regarding the International Business Diplomacy Training Program Center we want to develop next year in Romania, I'd like to give a very clear message. We aim to build something, not in competition, but in cooperation with all our allies, business partners, neighbors, and any other parties that share the same value with us. The diplomatic methods and techniques can be utilized not necessarily to better compete or conquer new territories. We Romanians, we never conquer any territory. But make better alliances, cooperate, develop business, and grow together as Europeans, for instance, on an offer-offer base, not necessarily on an offer-demand. And I will detail it at the end of the conference. Strategic business diplomacy may be used not only by large companies looking to expand in new markets, but also by local companies that they want to make strategic alliances with such giants and take benefit from globalization of the large international firms, as well as from the geopolitical changes, like Brexit, for instance. Although they must collaborate with their own government and diplomats, business people cannot depend on them as in the past. Romanian business executives themselves have to act as diplomats for their own business, and why not for their own country? Business people cannot blame their own country in a meeting and then invite their foreign partners to invest in their company. The purpose of this conference is to initiate an open professional debate on the existing but also potential unexplored synergies between diplomacy and business and offer a complex perspective of business diplomacy from many angles, by industry, by profession, by country, by culture. We are different. We are all different. We may speak the same language, but we are different. Therefore, we are pleased and honored to have 20 speakers today from Romania and abroad. I'll not take any of your time with my introductory speech, but take the chance to invite the distinguished Minister of Business Environment, Trade and Entrepreneurship to deliver the official opening speech.